Hi, boys and girls. This video will help you fill out the vocabulary page for Lesson 1-2, Proportional Relationships. All right, let's get over to that page here just a second. All right, this is the vocabulary page for proportional relationships. So what you want to do is you want to write the term proportional relationship here in the center. All right, the definition of a proportional relationship is a little wordy. Two quantities are in a proportional relationship if the two quantities vary and have a constant ratio between them. Feel free to pause the video if you want to write that down. Well, you should write that down because I'll be looking for it. Characteristics or drawings. What this means is that this little grouping of symbols and this little grouping of symbols are proportional. Here we have three circles to two triangles. And if I take these three circles and put these two triangles with them, then we would have six circles and four triangles. And 6 to 4 is proportional to 3 to 2. They have a constant ratio, right? An example would be here. It takes 2 spoons of chocolate syrup and 1 cup of milk to make chocolate milk. All right, so for every 1 cup of milk, we have to have 2 spoons of chocolate syrup. We have 2 cups of milk, we will have to have 4 chocolate syrups. We have 3 cups of milk, we will have to have 6 chocolate syrups. Okay, this is a proportional relationship. A non-example would be a relationship between two amounts that aren't proportional. Imagine Derek had twice as many PBIS points as Elijah, but then Elijah gets 50 more points. Right? Now they're no longer, the ratio between the two boys is no longer the same. Okay. So go ahead and pause this and get all this written down and make sure that you have it in your notebook when I come around to look for it. And enjoy the rest of your day.